Okay, so we've got flashing details here. Brick veneer, we've got the head flashing coming down the face of the structure and into the lintel. And that directs water out through the weep holes in the brick that the brick layer, and the mortar joint, sorry, in the bricks, that the brick layer leaves. Jam flashing comes over the top of the sill flashing, feeds out through that course of bricks there, through the mortar joints, through the weep holes in the mortar joints. Sliding door, the head is the same, but obviously we just have jam flashing down there.
Why did they paint the flashing down to the lintel years ago? Used to take the first course of brick above the window and have a weep hole there?
Because it's better to bring it down to the lintel, to get it out of the lintel, because it's directly above the window.
But wouldn't it be trapped in there at that stage?
Well, it can get trapped anywhere if it's not done properly. But it is better to come down onto the lintel and get it out the window rather than leave one course of bricks. There it is there in a detailed drawing down into the lintel. In a double brick situation, it has to be mortared into the inner skin of bricks. And in a cladding weatherboard type situation, the QBCC flashing's there, and you should always have an aluminium flashing above the head of the window as well. An external aluminium flashing in behind the cladding out over the top of the window. Concrete block, no reveal, therefore no DPC. Frame is fixed through the frame. The block is waterproofed with the membrane first. And this is the most critical feature here. To stop the water getting blown back into the top of the window. And these windows are generally fixed with an angle on each side. Now in that situation, the external angle is only a trim angle, so it's only there to cover sort of anything that's out of square, or just to cover the gap, because the window actually has to be smaller than the opening, otherwise it won't happen. So the trim angle covers that. The internal angle is sealed to the block, and that is the weatherproofing angle. Over the sill flashing, same thing. The sill flashing is usually 230 mils off the front of the reveal down into the lower course of brick there under the brick sill. Can go under the sill, but this is the preferred one down here. Now there's also a rubber flap on the sill of the window frame, which is there not to be taken out and discarded. That is there to sit down on top of the brick sill. Okay, to stop water getting blown up underneath there.
Tell the bricklayer that.
Beg your pardon?
Tell the bricklayer that.
Well, yeah.
Right.
If I knew all the bricklayers, I probably would. I've been on a lot of sites where I've tripped over them lying around on the background. Please don't do that. Here we've got double brick, and it's the same situation with the brick sill down under there and out through there. The same on the weatherboard cladding. Down, and it has to come out through the joint on that weatherboard. Okay? Now that's the sill flashing. The jam flashing is overlap the sill flashing. So it's directing any water that gets in around the window back out through the building without coming downstairs. And in a concrete sill situation, sliding door into a rebate. Now this one's got a Z flashing in underneath the door, and the concrete is all waterproof before that door goes in.
What do you mean,
Z
flashing
if
you're waterproof?
You don't need the Z flashing if you're waterproofing. That's just in there to show what can be done. Okay, I've got a couple of slides on that a bit further on, and I'll explain what an extra flashing underneath the sliding door can do.
Can you download this application off the website?
I believe these presentations are on the website and you can get them, yes.
Yes,
they are too. You'd better I'll come to that in a minute. Oh, I'm probably about 3 or 4 minutes. You got your clock off? Okay, jam flashings. Back in across the framing on all instances. Back in on the inner skin of brick, obviously on the concrete block there isn't one. And that overlaps the sill flashing. And it must overlap the sill flashing. Now jam flashings are usually 150 mils wide, and the sill flashing is usually about 230. Okay. monolithic cladding, blue board or green board or grey board or pink board or whatever colour board. Critical thing there is a head flashing. And behind the cladding, out over the top of the window.
But what's the bottom detail? Where's the seal rubber gone?
Well, you don't have it in that particular frame. That actually designer frame, you don't have that.
What stops that going back up under?
There's a batten here and the seal between the bottom of the window.
You do seal that?
Yeah.
So if moisture gets in there, where does that water go?
Well, moisture doesn't get in there because you've sealed it up along there. Moisture in the window frame gets in there and is drained out through the bead.
What if the jam and seal at the head interface is not actually properly sealed or the gas is not?
Then it hasn't been installed correctly.